everyone, welcome to Womanly. This is your host Shella, and today we are going to speak about emotional baggage. Yep, we're going there today. So let's begin with what is emotional baggage. Okay, so according to Wikipedia, emotional baggage is an everyday expression that correlates with many varied but similar concepts within social sciences, self-help movements, and other fields. Its general concern is with unresolved issues of an emotional nature, often with an implication that the emotional baggage is detrimental. As a metaphorical image, it is that of carrying all the disappointments, wrongs, and trauma of the past around with one in a heavy load. So in other words, emotional baggage literally means that something that happened in the past that has impacted you enough to have a negative consequences on your personal life right now in the present. For example, you had a bad childhood, your mom or your dad was mean to you, and that made you not trust people, that made you a different kind of person that you would have been had that experience not happened, not occurred in your past life. Emotional baggage has a negative connotation in popular culture, basically because people think that because something bad happened in the past, you're awful in the present. But I don't see emotional baggage as really a lot of baggage. I wouldn't use that term if I was talking about my own experiences. I would rather say it is more like a life lesson, because every bad thing that has ever happened to me in life, I do not carry it around as a baggage but as a life lesson. It has changed me, yes, but it has changed me better. For example, a bad experience about trust made you have trust issues with other people, so now you're not naive enough to trust just anyone and everyone. You are being more cautious about trusting people. Sometimes that can go a little too far when there are people who are trustable enough, but you're just being too cautious and you're not trusting them, you're always doubting them and suspecting them. But there's a fine line where you kind of see how much is okay and how much is too far, but no one else can define that line for you, and you can't say that it is a baggage, because I wouldn't say someone who's ever been bitten by a dog once will always be wary around other dogs when there are a lot of dogs around. So if you ever had a bad experience in life, it will always have an impact on you, and there will very few times be a chance in your life when you can begin to trust people again, or when you can be okay in a similar situation that happened in the past. So I don't think that emotional baggage is that bad of a term when it comes to your life in real life, because it depends on how you have used those bad past experiences to become a better person, if that makes any sense. So in this section, I want to talk about the three most common types of emotional baggage that you will see around. Number one, emotional baggage coming from your family. So if you have a negative effect coming from your own family, which means either your mom or your dad is really, really abusive or a negative person and always brings negative energy to the family, that may have a very serious impact on you. And this same goes with the families of the people you are in relationship with. So for example, you can also use this information to assess the family of your spouse or your girlfriend or your boyfriend. So if they have someone who is bringing a lot of negative energy, whether it's mom or dad or even a sibling, that's a lot of emotional stress, that's a lot of negative energy to deal with. So that person's mental stress would be obviously very high, and they would carry on that same negative energy to you, to your relationship. And in such cases, obviously you will have intimacy issues, you will have a chronic depression, and you may not feel yourself when you are even with the most trustable and loving person in the entire world, because of your own issues that are bagging you down from the past. Number two, the emotional baggage coming from the ex person, which means if there is an ex in this person's life, most adult mature relationships obviously have a past. if this person has dated someone in the past and not exactly closed off all connections, which means they are in touch with them a little bit here and there. They want to know what's up to in their life. They're stalking on Facebook and doing all those kinds of things. This person may still have an impact in their current life, and because of that, the current relationship might have a very bad impact. In this article that I read online that I'll share with you as well, they quoted the example from a movie called The Girl on the Train. That was a fantastic movie, a very good psychological thriller. I won't give you any spoilers here, but when you don't completely close the doors with your past, with your ex, that may still have the negative impacts no matter how great the relationship was. But if it ended, it ended for a reason, and give that reason enough credibility and just end it there. Otherwise, if you drag it along, you will never have a good present relationship. Third one is serious one, which is PTSD, post-traumatic stress syndrome, or any other kind of mental illness. But in this video, I want to specifically talk about PTSD. So if someone had a traumatic experience like rape, for example, any other kind of sexual assault, or any other kind of, I don't know, car crash, airplane crash, any other kind of very, very traumatic incident that, you know, shakes a person to their core, if they survived something so bad, that would always have an impact on them. And that is a kind of emotional baggage that needs very specific attention by the expert. It needs medical attention. You can't just get over it like this, and it may impact the person for a very long time. And if that is the case, if you or someone else, you know, your spouse, your girlfriend, your boyfriend is going through that kind of emotional baggage, please, 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 I beg you not to judge them, not to rush. If you're the one who's going through, not to rush yourself to move on and get over it, because this is something that can take years to go away. So give it time. If it's happened to you or to your partner, make sure that the person is safe now. The event has actually been passed completely and is not affecting them now personally directly. And know that this is the kind of baggage that may actually be around for a long time. So accept it. Accept the reality, be realistic. Instead of living in a fantasy like in the movies where something good happens and like this, the person forgets whatever happened, real life doesn't work that way. So this was it about emotional baggage. I hope you liked the video. If you have any kind of emotional baggage and you would just like to get it off your chest, share it in the comment section below. If there was something that I said wrong or you disagreed with, do let me know, and we can have a discussion, a civil discussion about it. And that's all for today's videos. I hope you give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Share it with your friends and your spouse or your partner, whoever you think might be able to use this information, and look out for the next one. Until then, take care, bye-bye.